there should have been dramatic warming, and then the satellites, when they actually take the temperature, it isn't happening.
Yeah.
And so I don't think we ought to enact public policy based on theories, particularly that are being disproven by the evidence. And I'm particularly concerned about proposals. Many of these so-called climate change proposals would dramatically drive up the electricity bills, the gas bills, the prices for people who are struggling. You know, if you're a single mom and you're trying to feed your kids, seeing your electric bill double is not something you can
hope. And do you think that if it were economical, that it would be something to put in practice?
Not unless the evidence supports it.
Okay, but if it did and it was economical, then you would
support
it.
The problem is, so there was an exchange I had a couple of weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
I chaired a hearing in the Senate, and the president of the Sierra Club testified. And I asked him just about the evidence and the data, and it was really striking. He couldn't answer the most basic questions about the facts. Now, that ought to trouble people. I mean, it was literally the subject of his entire written testimony and oral testimony.
Yeah, that's too bad.
And every time, hold on a second, every time I asked him a question, he would turn to his staffers and say, how do I answer this?
Yeah.
And what is going on? You know, I understand it, particularly among young people, you naturally have a passion to do good in the world. That's a great thing. I do think on an issue like global warming, some historical perspective is helpful. So, if you look back in the 1970s, there were a lot of liberal politicians and scientists arguing for global cooling, saying we were going to head into a massive ice age. And their policy solution was enormous government regulation of the energy sector, the economy, and every aspect of our life. Then the data disproved their theory. It became abundantly clear the Earth wasn't cool. Many of those very same liberal politicians came back, and then their theory was global warming. The exact opposite.
Yeah.
And interestingly enough,
so it's something that is certain and you see as a major.
But more than that, I think you were always on solid ground being skeptical of politicians. And every politician, look, be skeptical of me. Hold what I say and everyone else to account. But you looked at the liberal politicians, they said global warming justified massive increases in government control over our lives. Then, when the satellite data didn't back that up, notice that it changed a third time. It changed climate change. Is the perfect pseudo-scientific theory for a big government liberal because you can never disprove it. Like, I am the son of two scientists. Both my parents were mathematicians and computer programmers. Climate change is a perfect bogus theory because whether it gets hotter or colder, whether it gets wetter or drier, it's always proven right. The climate has changed every day the Earth has been in existence, and it will continue changing until the end of time. So, a theory that is never proven wrong, if we didn't have a single internal combustion engine, we'd still have climate change, because climate changes. And the very same people who were arguing for global cooling and arguing for global warming are now arguing for climate change. Their solution, again, is they want more power over the economy and your lives. And you start to think, God, maybe these are just politicians who want to have power over your and my life. And that, I think, leads a lot of people naturally to be very skeptical of the wrong-headed theories.
So, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.